Hi there, welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, consider subscribing and hitting the notification bell to get updated each time I upload a new video. If not, welcome back. Please consider liking the video and sharing it so that we can push on the algorithm to like us. So today on this episode of Young and Ambitious in Africa, A Touch of History, we'll be discussing from Kemet to Egypt, the conquests that happened over time in what is now known as Egypt and was known as Kemet. Starting us off is the Hyksos, which happened during the second intermediary period. It was founded by Salaites, who was a leader or a Hyksos from West Asia. Salaites conquered and ruled Lower Egypt. At this point, Upper and Mid Egypt were still led by some pharaohs, and it went through approximately from 1650 to 1550 BC. This period was mainly marked by the 15th, 16th, and 17th dynasties. So I'll leave this link in the description so that you can learn more on what happened during this second intermediate period. Next were the Meshwesh, which was an ancient Libyan tribe that originally were prisoners of war under the pharaoh at that time, and their descendants then grew to become some leaders. Like, for instance, in the 22nd dynasty, the Meshwesh leader Shoshenq I, who is believed to be the one depicted on the Sphinx, ruled Egypt among other leaders. And also, during the 23rd dynasty, the major ruler was Hasiese A. There's a longer name, you can find it in the link in the description. I'll be leaving description links for you to read on and learn more about this stuff. So later on in the 25th dynasty, the Nubians conquered, after the Meshwesh had caused a bit of some form of decay to the practices, languages, and everything in Egypt at the time, which was then known as Kemet, I believe. The Nubians from the kingdom of Kush decided to raid Egypt, and the leader at that time who founded who came to restore the first one was the great pharaoh Pe. They were devoted and had a keen emphasis on bringing back the religions, the art, and the literary tradition. So they used the language, Egyptian language, Egyptian practices, and everything. Before him, the Kemet, the Meshwesh people were focused on destroying culture, destroying art, and just some form of revenge against the Egyptians and to divide everything. But the Nubians, their target or their goal was to restore order and restore the religious practices and traditions and sciences of the Egyptian people. I'll also leave this link in the description so that you can check more on that. Now, later on the 27th dynasty, the Persians conquered Egypt. In the 27th dynasty, the king of Persia, known as Cambyses, I hope the pronunciation is right, Cambyses II ruled and founded the 27th dynasty in Egypt after conquering this place. There was a whole war, and there's a whole explanation in this link. I'll leave it in the description. Much later, after the Egyptians gained control, and then much later in the 31st dynasty, there was another conquer by the Persians, and which was founded by Artaxerxes the third. Forgive my pronunciation. There's a whole story on how he conquered Egypt, led Egypt. There was an attack by the Nubians again, gained control, he regained control. Then later on, he was conquered by Alexander the Great in the Greek period. The first Argead dynasty was under the Alexander the Great. He has a whole name, there's a whole link there you can learn about him. After he conquered the kingdom of Persia, therefore Egypt came under his control since Egypt was under the Persian kingdom at that time. After his dynasty, then came the Ptolemaic dynasty, which was characterized by leaders such as Ptolemy the First and Ptolemy the Second, and later on the last pharaoh, the last queen, and the last pharaoh, who was Cleopatra. There's a whole explanation on that. I'll also leave that in the description below. After this, we'll be discussing the dynasties, and I think I'll divide this by period since there's a lot of dynasties and I don't want to miss much. I'll just explain who was the leader and all that more in that video. So before I close, this is probably wise I mentioned that this periods and this conquest, I've explained just the leader that founded this dynasties and founded these places and conquered, but I did not list the kings and leaders that followed after this, the founder of this period. To read more, there will be links and you can find them in the description below. Thank you very much for watching this video. Please consider liking, sharing, and subscribing if you're not subscribed yet. See you next time. It's been an honor. Bye bye.